Hello everybody and welcome to some more Hearthstone. Goblins and Gnomes is out! Yay! There's 120 new ridiculous cards and we're going to see some of them today, aren't we? I've got all new gimmick decks for every class. It's going to be great. And I'm going to go back and redo some of my old gimmick decks. I'm going to do some new gimmick decks that I had planned, and then Goblins and Gnomes was announced and I was like, oh shit, some of those will be amazing for that. So there's loads. There's going to be loads more coming from me in the future. So today I thought I'd start off by showing the Chaos deck. Now, it is a priest deck, obviously, as you can tell. What's it about? Well, you may notice from glancing at this that everything in here has a random effect of some description. It's a bit similar to those Randuin decks that were going around a while ago, but different for two key reasons. Firstly, I didn't call it Randuin Rin, or however you pronounce his name, because that would just be stealing, and that's not what we're about on this show if you ignore the fact that I stole the format and the idea and the concept and everything from Total Biscuit. But let's ignore that, shall we? And let's go on to the second thing. The second thing is, this deck is entirely minions, there's no spells, and every single one, as I said, does something random. Whether it's hitting something random, or summoning something random, or stealing something random, in the case of the lone mind control tech in there. Now, the numbers are a little odd in this deck. Like, I have one mind control tech, and I have one Kezan Mystic, and one piloted Sky Golem. So, and one Young Priestess, and one Master Swordsmith. So, you're probably looking at this and going, this looks kind of weird, I don't really get why I did this. And the reason is, when I decided that there would be no spells in here, so I couldn't have Mind Vision, or Mind Games, which is further along, I decided I couldn't have them, so I just wanted minions. So, when I did that, I realized there were so many random minions, minions that have random effects on things, actually in the game now with Goblins and Gnomes, because it adds so many. I decided that I would just do my favorites, the ones I thought would fit best, and leave the others. But there's a couple in here pretty much for utility, so we'll go through them quickly. Young Priestess, 2-1 for 1. At the end of your turn, give them another random friendly minion plus 1 health. I'll be honest, that was kind of to bring up the numbers, because that's my only one drop, and I only have one of them. So, turn one, I don't like never being able to play something on turn one, basically, and that can be handy. Especially if I throw out Knife Juggler on turn two and it becomes a 3-3 for two, which deals damage, that's nice. Random damage, that is. So yeah, so we've got Young Priestess, that's fine, everybody knows that. Two Knife Jugglers, 3-2 for two, after you summon a minion, deal one damage to a random enemy, that's excellent, fits very nicely in this deck, not much more to say. Mad Bomber, 3-2 for 2. Battlecry, deal 3 damage randomly split between all other characters. That's just as likely to hurt me as much as it hurts the enemy. But it's random, so it fits this deck. Master Swordsmith, at the end of your turn, give another random friendly minion plus 1 attack. Same reason as the Young Priestess, but it was kind of... This one, I won't lie, was there just kind of to fill up the numbers. If I replace a card, it'll be him going first, I think. So then we have some new cards. Shadow Boxer, and I have a shiny golden one. Look at that. Isn't that shiny and golden and purple and pink and colours, isn't that lovely? So, whenever a character is healed, it's a 2-3 for 2, whenever a character is healed, deal 1 damage to a random enemy. So I can heal myself if I get hurt, and then, bing, heal damage an enemy. So that's a pretty cool card. It's a 2-3 for 2, so it's already decent, but then that extra effect is lots of fun with a priest, and it is a priest-specific card. It's also a mech, but I don't have anything that really combos with mechs in here particularly. So, Dark Cultist, 3-4 for 3, Death Rattle, give a random friendly minion plus 3 health. That's fine, that's a pretty good minion, it's pretty solid. Even if you can't make use of the Death Rattle, it's still a pretty solid minion. Demolisher, 1-4 for 3. At the start of your turn, deal 2 damage to a random enemy. Again, random, it's not a very fast card, but it's random, so that's what we want. Mind Control Tech, overdid that. Mind Control Tech, a 3-3 for 3. Battle Cry, if your opponent has 4 or more minions, take control of one at random. I debated... having a Mind Control Tech in, or just having another piloted Sky Golem in, but I went for the Mind Control Tech in the end because I thought it adds a bit more utility and it's definitely pretty random, so that's something. So we'll put him in. Tinkmaster Overspark, Battlecry, transform another random minion into a 5-5 Devilsaur or a 1-1 Squirrel, 3-3 for 3. This used to be a great card when it was, I think it was a 2-2 for 3 and you could target your ability, so loads of high level players just used it to remove anything that was bigger than 5-5. You would just get either a 5-5, or best case scenario, you'd get a 1-1 to face, so that was really good. I say high level players, I didn't, because I wasn't high enough to make use of it, really. I had it, but I was just like, why do I need that? I'm still in the scrub leagues down here. I don't need that. So yeah, it's less good now, but it's now random, so it goes in the deck. In she goes. In he goes. Right, don't know why I said she. It's not a ship, it's a gnome. I think it's a gnome. Is he a gnome? I'm pretty sure he's a gnome. He'll fit well in a gnome deck. Enhanzo Meccano, a 3-2 for 4. Battlecry, give your other minions Wind Fury, Taunt, or Divine Shield at random. I love this card. It's not particularly good, but it is fun, and it definitely fits well in this deck. Each of your minions will get either Wind Fury or Taunt or Divine Shield. You can't have one minion getting multiple things. So if you've got one minion, it'll get Wind Fury, Taunt, or Divine Shield. If you have five minions, boom, all but the Enhancer Meccano will get something. And it's great fun. It's great fun. It really is. So yeah, not a great card, but a fun one. Kezan Mystic, a 4-3 for 4. Battlecry, take control of a random enemy secret. This is in here, A, for random, and B, for the fact that, hey, it's pretty cool if I come up against an enemy secret, and I've not actually had a chance to use it yet either, because every time I've had it in any of my decks, which is not that often, admittedly, nobody's played any bloody secrets, so it's nice to have her in. This one is a her. Nice to have her in, and I'm pretty sure she is a goblin. Piloted Shredder, a 4-3 for 4. Death Rattle, summon a random 2-cost minion. Now, this is fun. Obviously, the Death Rattle constitutes the random part. I have had one of these before pull Milhouse Mana Storm. So I got a 4-4, well, I got a 4-3 that when it died summoned a 4-4 and I didn't have his negative battlecry effect. So that was excellent. I'm pretty sure Milhouse Mana Storm is the best possible draw you can get for this, but it won't just summon neutral and whatever class you're playing as at the time, 2-cost minions. It'll summon any 2-cost minion. So you could end up with, I don't know, a Druid 2-cost minion. I can't think of it off the top of my head now. How dreadfully embarrassing. So you can end up with any 2-cost minion, including Milhouse Mana Storm, as said. So that's fun. Of course, it's very variable, so you could end up with something dreadful as well. Like, well, I wouldn't say the Master Swordsmith is dreadful, but something worse than the Master Swordsmith, basically. You could end up with a 2-1 Murloc, which would be really, really unlucky. So, the Blingtron 3000. This is another one I love, because it's just insane. A 3-4 for 5, not great at all, pretty terrible, but Battlecry, equip a random weapon for each player. That's so much fun. Again, not very useful, especially since my opponents seem to keep getting gore howls and I keep getting the bloody ogre weapon that hits has a 50% chance to miss. But it's brilliant fun, and then it's just like, oh hey, well, I'm a priest. No, yeah, that's right, throw out your acidic swamp poos and bam, weapon, motherfucker. I mean, so do you, but still, bam. So that's just great fun. Another card that I absolutely love. Again, not very good, but fun. And random as hell. Bomb Lobber. A 3-3 for 5. Battlecry, deal 4 damage to a random enemy minion. That one's actually not bad. The 3-3 for 5, obviously pretty terrible. But 4 damage to a random enemy minion. That'll clear a lot of stuff. 4 damage is not to be sniffed at, especially in the mid game. So that's pretty good. We got 2 of those in there. Not much to say about that, but yeah, that's good. A Madder Bomber. 5-4 for 5. Battlecry, deal 6 damage randomly split between all other characters. Again, like the Mad Bomber above, it's just... It's random. It can really harm you, or it can really harm your opponent, or it can just do a balance. It's fun, it's random, it's in. Stampede Encoder. 3-5 for 5. Battlecry, destroy a random enemy minion with 2 or less attack. That's actually a really good card. Like, in most decks, that's a good card. So, yeah, they throw out something with 2 or less attack. Bam, dead. Random, still fits, excellent, no complaints. Piloted Sky Golem, a 6-4 for 6. Death Rattle, summon a random 4-cost minion. That's pretty much the same as the Piloted Treader, just a more powerful version. So that's nice, that summons a 4-cost minion. So you could get a lot of fun things for 4, actually. You can't get Leroy Jenkins anymore because he's now 5. So that's a shame. Yeah, that's that. Sylvanas Windrunner, 5-5 for 6, Death Rattle, take control of a random enemy minion, don't need to say anything for her, just good, always good to have, always have her in a deck if possible. Ragnaros, 8-8 for 8, can't attack at the end of your turn, deal 8 damage to a random enemy. Again, always a bloody solid choice. You throw out Ragnaros, if they don't have something to deal with him, things are going to get very painful very fast for them. So Ragnaros, excellent choice. And another new card, Sneed's Old Shredder, a 5-7 for 8, Death Rattle, summon a random legendary minion. Now, That is great. Like, that's, I mean, it's not, again, not necessarily great in terms of good, but great in terms of fun. And I love this card for that reason. It's the same reason I'm liking all these other random things. There's just so many random elements in now. So, I mean, on this, you could get a Milhouse Mana Storm, which is, you know, not amazing. You could get Lore Walker Cho, not amazing. Or you could pull Deathwing and get a 12-12 with no downside. So that's pretty fun. Or, I mean, theoretically, you could pull Sneed's Old Shredder, or possibly even you could pull Kel'Thuzad, who would then resurrect Sneed's Old Shredder, which would just be amazing. I would love to see that happen. So that's the deck, the Chaos deck. This deck is not designed to win. I'll say that now. It is not designed to do well. It is not designed to be effective. It is designed to be as random as fuck, as the name implies, and just cause absolute mayhem. So, without further ado, let's get right on it. And see how she does in the ranked. I'm ranked 16 at the moment, as you may be able to notice. I'm not great at ranked play, even at the best of times, if I was using good decks, but I keep going at it with my gimmick decks now, so it's just silly. I mean, I get to a certain point, which is probably about this threshold, where I just want people to get higher because players who are actually good using actual good decks are there, and they're like, the fuck are you doing? Get back down there. And I'm just booted back down to the scrub leagues, so. But hey-ho, hey-ho. We shall see how we do.
Anduin,
a hunter. Lovely.
Rexxar!
Let the hunt begin.
The light shall bring victory.
Not actually bad. I'll keep the knife juggler and the bomber. And a young priestess. Very nice. A young priestess who I'm not going to play on turn one, because if he plays something and I throw out the bomber next turn, the young priestess is liable to die. So we'll save her. Ooh, a gold Bloodfen Raptor. That's a basic card, so Christ knows what rank you have to be in what class to get that gold. I have no... Oh, I dislike that. Can the Mad Bomber come through and do the damage for us? Absolutely sodding not, but let's see it try. Well, he gave it his best shot. He may have just lobbed two bits of dynamite back at my face, but he gave it his best shot. Okay, I don't like how many golden cards this hunter has. This doesn't bode well at all. Okay, so we're going to Knife Juggler. Young Priestess, please, please, please hit the Raptor.
Job done.
Fuck. Well, isn't that awkward? That could have gone much better. Never mind. This is the risky run with a random deck. Aww. Kodo, you'll be handy next turn, but not this turn. Actually, you won't be handy next turn because I'm killing off his board. Oh. I did just trade down that Mad Bomber, Knife Juggler, rather, because at least this way he doesn't have anything on the board.
To my side.
I was really hoping for Leok there. You know what would be really good is if he played a weapon that turn, because then I could just overrun it with this weapon. Fuck. Oh, okay, so he got a Coghammer, which didn't get its Battle Cry, so that's just a 2-3. I got a 3-4. That's pretty nice. Assassin's Blade. Oh, that's something. The Blingtron, well, even though he's not golden, the weapons he summons are always golden, from what I've noticed. So, yeah, I mean, well, I say noticed. It's fairly obvious. But hey, I got a 3-3 weapon now. That's nice. Again? Really? Fucking hell. I don't have a single taunt in this deck, so this is going to end badly. Ooh. I would like my taunt thing. I know what I mean. I'm actually going to have to hit that. If it's a freezing trap, then I'm in trouble. It's not. I actually have to hit that because I can't afford to take more damage. No explosive trap either. Okay. So it's probably... It's not a snake trap. It's not freezing trap. It's not explosive trap. It's not misdirection. Or does misdirection only count for minions? Can't remember. Quite possibly snipe then, in which case I will play him and get a random 2+ It's not snipe. Okay, which secrets have I forgotten? Huh. I actually can't remember. There must be another secret, another hunter secret, but I can't remember. What the hell am I thinking of? Oh, there's another one. Oh lord. If ever I needed that secret stealing minion, whose name I can't remember, it's now. It's definitely now. Oh boy. It is a character attacks you. Okay, so I guess I couldn't hit him with stuff. Please be freezing trap. No. Wow, this game's over pretty quick, isn't it? That is freezing trap, though. That... Never combo misdirection and freezing trap. It's a dreadful, dreadful play. And
that didn't.
No, you're damn right it didn't. It's a dreadful play and you should feel bad for doing it. Let's just go nuts. Oh my god, Bomber, you are the worst fucking team player I have ever seen in my life. Holy crap. That was literally, you could not have done any worse then. You could have blown yourself up and it would have been better than that. Bloody hell. Alright, can he do one extra damage to me? I'm gonna guess yes. Yeah, there we go. Oh wow. I didn't have much hope in that one, I'm not gonna be honest. I'm not gonna lie. He's clearly an experienced player and he rushed me straight in the face. Yeah, I was not likely to survive that. Never mind. Let's go again. And hopefully this time the bomber will actually do his fucking work instead of just hitting me in the face three times in a row when I'm really low on health. What a bastard. Oh well. Oh well. Such is the random deck. You can't get annoyed at randomness when playing the random deck because that just completely defeats the point. Who are we against this time then?
Anduin versus Malfurion.
I must protect the wild.
Double. Oh, there's the Kezan Mystic. Victory. Yeah, it would have been nice to have you around here last time. Yeah, I'm just going to keep that because that's a decent mana curve. Alright then. So it's looking like Mad Bomber turn 2, especially if he plays something. Alright then, let's go. If I'd got a good 2-drop, I might have coined out the bomber, but I didn't, so I won't.
Hello, hello, hello.
That's a pretty good target for the bomber, actually.
You wanna blow something up?
Or not! Apparently the bomber feels differently in this matter. Actually, I don't want to play Tinkmaster next turn. Because there's no point in my bomber being a 5-5 in this stage. And I really don't want to give that thing, turn that thing into a 5-5. Though, of course, it could remove its divine shield if it would turn into a 1-1, so that'd be pretty swish.
It's clobbering time!
Ah, the thing says that. Okay, I might Tink Master now, actually. And I might move his divine shield first just in case this gets hit. Don't fail me, Tink Master! See that, Tinkmaster? That's what we would put under failing me.
My thanks.
Please stop doing that. That was so dreadful. That was really bad. It's fine though. It's fine. I still have a plan. Kinda. I have 12% of a plan. I can coin out the bomb lobber. Hopefully this'll die. And the bomb lobber can hit that. And I can hit it with whatever's left. Depends if he hero powers. He's considering it. Please don't. Damn. Double damn. Okay. That bomb lobber's not going to be a lot of help now. Ah, Shadow Boxer. Yeah, not really gonna do it. Not really gonna do it. Blinktron, hope for a good weapon, but he's still behind a taunt. Oh boy, am I in trouble. Well, he's unlikely to have much to heal him, so I think I will actually just... God fucking damn it. Oh, he hit the 1-2. He hit the 1-2. Bastard. Okay, what are we looking at? Stalag! Excellent! Excellent! Good! Tremendous! Oh god. What else do you have? Please just... Oh good, nothing. Christ. Ah! Another one to save the day! That I'm actually okay with, because I didn't take 7 fucking damage. So I'm actually good with that one. Okay, next turn it'll probably be the Kezan Mystic Heal. I'm pretty much gonna have to heal every turn from here on, I think. I should get a better draw, of course. If he's got any sense, he'll run the 5-2 into my face. Because he knows I'm gonna trade it for the 3-3. I'm gonna trade the 3-3 for it more accurately. Because I can't leave it there. Pink Master, you have ruined. Oh! Look for me face. Okay, it's probably gonna kill me this turn. I'm not gonna kill him, this is gonna pile the shredder instead. Question is, can he do 6 damage? Or did he just forget that I can heal? Actually, if he has a Starfall, then he can do 6 damage. Which is the one that does 6 damage itself and draws a card? Does that do 5 damage and draw a card? You know, I can't actually remember. Don't use it very often. Okay. What does he have?
Some
Sludge Belcher, right? Ow. Ow. Get something good. Not that. That is dreadful. That is one of the worst things I could possibly have got. Currently I'm dead, so let's just heal up and hope it hits that. Not what I was after, really. Currently I'm one away from dead, unless he has some direct damage in those 3 cards, which he probably does. It feels like that sort of game. I feel like he probably has some. I'll play Ragnaros next turn either if I survive, because I have to heal, otherwise he'll be able to kill me just with his hero power. It's assuming his minions don't kill me first. He can't. I'm guessing he doesn't have direct damage in his hand, otherwise he would have probably used it by now in order to kill me, which he could totally do. Currently he is one short of lethal.
I wonder.
Yeah. Well, Moonfire will kill me, but I very much doubt he's got Moonfire. No, currently I'm still kind of dead. Yep, pretty much dead.
Well played.
Shut your face. Oh, an out has appeared. Not really, but kinda. Damn it. Damn it. But wait! Enhanzo Mikado! Yes! Give the 2-1 taunt. That's exactly what I wanted. Brilliant. Couldn't have given him taunt. I'd have much preferred that. Okay. Okay then. Nope. Still dead. Still dead. Yeah. Oh well. Yeah, I'm still dead.
You have better.
Although, have I done the maths right? Was I right about the maths? Yeah, I was right about that. Oh, and he had some direct damage as well. Okay, not an auspicious start for this deck. Let's try again, shall we? I'm hoping this deck does pick up, because as I said, it's not meant to win, but it's discouraging to lose over and over again. Just because it's not meant to win doesn't mean I don't want it to win.
Anduin versus Rexxar!
Let the hunt begin.
The light shall bring victory.
We don't need 2 Kodos there, do we? Thus far, I really hope this guy isn't a rush as well, because thus far I haven't even managed to get up long enough to get any of my bloody, you know, good legendaries in. That's not very good. What have you got, Rhino?
Greetings, traveler.
Greetings, Rhino.
Greetings.
Yeah, if I play her, she dies to the bomber, so no. You think, oh, Tom, you don't have to play the bomber in turn two. Nope, but I have to. I want to play something, and I got fuck all else to do. I should go trade it with that. But then I'd have 2-1-1s to deal with, and who wants to be fiddling about with them? So close. So close. Oh well, it still can't kill him in one turn, so that's good. Which is actually, yeah, that's pretty decent, because the spiders could, if you threw them out. If they came out, rather. Let's see what he got. Arcane shot. Eagle horn bow. Out. Fucking standing. Right. Arts and Meccano's no good here, so I think we'll just... No. Oh, she's no good here either. She just turns one damage into two damage. So we'll leave her. Next turn we can coin into... I think the Madder Bomber would be fun. Yes, the Madder Bomber. Well, actually, I'd like that gone first, when I think on it. Because then the Mad Bomb can kill its spawn. Ah, well, never mind. We'll have time for that later. Go, Mad Bomber! Alright, 4 to him. Well, 3 to him, 1 to his minion, and 1 to me. I'll take that. I'm good with that. I've seen worse. Like all your predecessors of the ordinary Mad Bomber variety, for example, to take a completely random choice. Probably. I'm going to be hoping that I trigger that secret. I'd love to get my secret stealer again. I can't remember her name at all, so I'm just going to keep calling her my secret stealer. I'd love to get her and pinch that. I didn't get her, but I did get my demolisher, so that's fine. He can't even kill it with the bow, even if he wanted to. So hopefully, he, for some reason, will play something with 2 health now. Wouldn't that be nice? Can't imagine he's likely to, though. It's turn 6. He's probably going to play a Savannah High Main or something. No, unlikely. Nope, he did. What do you know? What do you know? Oh, boy. Excellent. 6-3. Just terrific. Oh, or I could just... Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, wasn't that fun? Not gonna run this in on account of the... That. Excellent, that's what I was hoping would be buffed, so it won't die just to the hyenas and leave them both alive. Jolly good. Okay. Right. Kezen Mystic, that's her name. Possibly, I think, maybe, perhaps. So the question now is, what comes next? Indeed, Rhino. Indeed. Next turn I will probably enhance him. I don't like where this is going. Cool, okay. Still don't really like where this is going, I must admit, but... We'll take it. Oh, double enhancer mechanic. I'm just going to do it so I have something else for this guy to enhance. Ah, double taunt. Nice.
More training.
Cool. So, let's not snake trap or cruising trap. So, it could be explosive trap or it could be misdirection. And it's not snipe. Okay then. Right, I'm good with this. Uh-oh.
It's time for sure.
All right. That's helpful. Good. We're not playing the Mad Bomber here. We're definitely not doing that. Okay, he already had divine thanks, you little...
Who are you?
Oh, if that is misdirection, if it's, I don't want to trigger that yet, whatever it is, so I'm actually going to pass, and he can attack who he likes, and I'll clear him next turn. But damn, do I like this card, incidentally. A 6-9 for 7, whenever this minion takes damage, double its attack! That's insane! No, 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 no! Okay, the stats were on my side there, so it wasn't likely he'd actually hit that.
I let the dogs out. Oh.
Well, this is bad. Well, this is bad. Oh, his Wind Fury will avail him naught. Never mind. And their Divine Shields are gone as well, so... That fucking damage! Oh god! Okay, we'll just throw him out. One more heal. Definitely, definitely heal. Ooh. Mercy. Don't worry. Hopefully this 6-4 will be enough to frighten him into taking it out directly.
To my side.
Da.
Some's
da. That's not great, but okay. Bomb.
Wanna blow something up?
Good enough. Okay. Okay, so neither of those are particularly good draws for us, but I can at least get... I don't want to take 4 more damage, but I can get through it. Okay. That can trade with that, which is kind of annoying, but hey-ho. We're okay. We're doing okay. I mean, we're not great. He's got more cards, more health, and a secret. But... we could be doing a lot worse. We've done a lot worse, in fact, previously. In the last... The last games. There's a problem with no spells.
Join or die. Or both.
God. He's only one card ahead of me. Fucking hell. This is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt even more. Alright. I need... Sneed's old Shredder. Lovely. Wouldn't that be great if I had enough damage takeable? Let's just... I mean, I'm... Yeah, I'm dead. I don't even know why I'm doing this. I just did the maths. I'm dead.
You have best.
Wow. Okay, this deck is just as bad as I expected. I didn't play well. Fuck off with your well played. I played terribly. Did you not see how bad my deck was? It's full of crap. Alright, let's do one more. Because I'd really like to try and win one. I actually won 2 in a row in my testing when I was just asking about with it. Oh. Maybe this deck will be better placed in play mode rather than in casual mode rather. Instead of ranked mode. Because... damn it. Even at low ranks, people are at least trying. The best way for me to win is to be up against opponents who really don't give a shit. Ah, now against a shaman, my mind control tech could be kind of handy. That's fucking handy again. Probably don't play either. Good, so we've got some plays come turn 5. Which is a bit of a way away. And it's a Shaman Murloc deck. Because of the new Murloc cards. Put her out to trade. This is trouble. Incidentally, my Shaman gimmick deck is a Shaman Murloc deck. This is so good now. It's just like, hey, have some more Murlocs. And hey, have a Shaman legendary that summons more Murlocs. Enjoy your Murlocs, motherfucker. Oh, and he can trade that. Yeah. So, yeah, that's that. Coin? He doesn't trade. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to climb. See, I mean, this doesn't train either, but it might hit him. And this, he would have to summon two Murlocs to kill it. Whereas the Master Swordsmith, he'd only have to summon one. Or he could do that. Hey, he summoned two anyway. Isn't that exciting?
Isn't that exciting? Oh, fucking hell.
Ah, Shadow Boxer. Nope. Not playing him yet. I'll play him next turn when I can then heal. But at least my 1-3 trades with everything there. Like, it'll trade with any of them, but... He can hit it with a Murloc Raider, which is the worst... Oh, God! Well, this is quickly getting out of control, isn't it? Kodo! No, you're not even any help!
Oh, no, 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 no.
Come on, hit that guy. All that guy. That knocks off a fair bit of damage, actually. Not enough damage, but hey-ho, never fucking mind. Concede. Wow, this deck is dreadful. I'm just shedding ranks like a snake shedding its skin, but more often and with reckless abandon. So not at all like a snake shedding its skin, actually completely different. Okay, that was dreadful. That was awful. Yeah. Cool. Well, I guess we'll end it there then on that dreadfully low note. Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know which of these decks you'd like to see in the next video. Comment down below. And yeah, they're not all actually ready yet, but I'm not going to tell you which ones aren't ready, so it's not very helpful. But if there's one you'd particularly like to see, like perhaps this one, this one here, just no. Just this one, possibly, maybe. I mean, I'm not trying to put any ideas in your head, but if you were to choose one, I would suggest this deck. Not least because of the funny name, but also because of the fact that it's the only deck that's actually any fucking good at the moment. I've been playing this just casually, and it's just actually okay. Whereas, terrible, 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 pretty good, actually, terrible. So, yeah, this one. We'll probably do this one, but we might do another. Let me know what you want, and I will do my best to accommodate you. So thank you for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.